Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Banger Music Hour. Local, on their way to being huge rock stars. We're so proud of you guys. Eva Under Fire, thank you for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, what's up, man? Thank you.
Now, it's incredible. You guys have a song that's coming out, or is out, on a soundtrack called Snow Babies, and it's about combating drug epidemic. Now, could you tell me a little bit about the song?
Yeah, crazy. What happened? We were writing our initial album. I just so happened to have a personal issue in my life where I wrote this song called Heroin. And it was something I was real close to. So I said, well, I don't know what's going to happen with it, but let's submit it, see what goes on. And the label got a hold of it and said, you know what? This is perfect. We have this movie called Snow Babies coming out. This song has to be on the soundtrack. So it's just kind of an awesome thing that lined up that way.
Now, how long did it kind of take from the conception of the song to the final product where you're actually going to be on the soundtrack?
Well, you kind of like swing and a miss 40 million times before they accept a lot of the stuff. And it just basically pushes you to be the best musician that you can be. So, I mean, we were in the studio for at least a year when we finally submitted all the final tracks for the album. So, I mean, and that timeline just so happened to line up with this movie. So it was just great timing.
And what was the process in writing this song?
Lots of tears for me. It's a very personal story. So it was a really emotional roller coaster. And, you know, lots of work with and patience from our producers and the guys, you know, had a lot of input too on all the different parts. So it was really just a bunch of us that came together in our producer's basement to say, look, this is a real emotional story. We should make this a priority. And we did.
And you came up with like the original guitar riff, or was it lyrics that came first, or how was that all put together?
It was definitely a lyrics first in this particular instance. There were some times we brought guitar riffs first, and there was other times where the producers came to the table with some ideas, and so it kind of all like blends together. But for me, with this one, it's a real personal story, so it was definitely lyrics first for that particular song.
Yeah, for the music side, it was really just kind of like we had a tempo and like that electronic drum beat, and we were like, okay, this is kind of cool, let's roll with that.
And you wrote the guitar lines and the bass off of that.
Yeah, that kind of goes with when you figure out what key the song is going to be in, and then you kind of go with that. This is more of a simple song from a musical side of it. So we had the structure, the chord progression going, and then Amanda was able to come up with the melodies and the lyrics from there. And then you kind of fill in around her.
You guys have been around what? How many years as a band?
5 years.
I remember seeing you down at like the Token Lounge and stuff when you guys were gigging early on as the band, and I watched the progression. And even the band before, how everything kind of changed over, and it you guys have really like sweetened that sound. It's great for radio. And like I said earlier, we're really proud of you over here, and just it's amazing. Now, some of my listeners will bug me if I don't ask you this, and I know it's a little off the topic of the single. And we'll get back to the single, but how did you guys come up with the band name?
That's an interesting story. Name Eva actually came from a song reference, and then we wanted to put some power behind it. So it was much more of that conceptual uphill battle, you know, as a female-fronted artist. So Eva Under Fire just seemed appropriate.
Is this like a first step for an album? What's coming after this single? Is this like a launching pad for you for something?
Definitely is the launching pad. We have no idea for what, because of course all of our plans immediately changed when the world shut down. So it was like, you know, we have all these great expectations of, you know, like, okay, here it is, we turned in, we've got all our songs approved for the new album. So a new album is coming. The song Heroin is on the new record. It is the first release from the new record, and we're hoping to get the conversation going about Eva Under Fire with its release, and also, of course, being on the soundtrack with the Snow Babies film with other, you know, heavy hitters, man, like Bad Wolves is on the soundtrack, so many awesome bands. but definitely new records coming, and it was supposed to have been tied to some epic proportion tour. And then touring shut down. So short answer to your question is we have no idea, but we absolutely need to roll out with a vengeance, regardless of what this world looks like. So I guess that's kind of like the most rock and roll thing we can do right now, right?
That's
no
right.
No plan, just do it.
Now, speaking of a tour, you do have some shows coming up in Lake Orion and the Token Lounge. You want to talk about that?
Yeah, we do. What is it, 313 Pizza Bar in Lake Orion? That's going to be a fun show, man. And that one's the benefit, right?
Yeah.
So the proceeds for this particular show that's coming up next week in Lake Orion go to this men's group that is trying to raise awareness for breast cancer.
Yeah, I believe it's Real Men Wear Pink.
Yeah, yeah. Which is real cool, right? I'm like, this is kind of a neat cause that, and I'm excited to get a chance to meet those guys. We've worked with the promoter that set us up with the show before, and it was a real fun time, so we're looking forward to that. And then, of course, we've got the show at Token coming up with Kick and Valentina, which is going to be sweet. That was supposed to have happened back in April, and finally, we were able to set this date up and move forward with the show. So we've been looking forward to this one for a long time.
Now, will bands be able to buy physical copies of the new song Heroin at these shows?
No, sir. Unfortunately, we have our previous release of our EP called Heavy on the Heart is the song, the disc that we have. And we're sort of in a sell-off period. So if you would like to come and purchase those from us, that'd be awesome. And they're collector's items because there's going to be an interesting amalgam of different songs on the new record, which you'll see eventually. But that won't happen until probably early 2021.
Right. And your new record, that's under a new record label that you recently signed with, am I correct? Like within the last year or so?
Yeah, you got it, man.
Now, how's that been like?
It's the type of relationship that plays with your emotions.
Up and down, up and down, huh?
Yeah, we love them dearly, but we know that they're toying with us in some way. It mostly, quite honestly, is because we were so ready with this new release, finally, and then the world shut down. So a lot of it is just terrible timeline.
Right.
And then everybody's scrambling, trying to figure out what to do for us. But one thing I'm grateful for, I thought for sure, we're a baby band that doesn't have a new release at all on this label yet. You know, why wouldn't they wait and just hold off on everything until the world opens back up? And that's not what they did. They chose to roll out with this song, Heroin. They chose to continue, pushing forward with different, we've been part of podcast interviews. We've gotten a chance to sort of Zoom meet a couple of cool rock stars and write some tunes. And we still are in their game and in their mind, so we appreciate that. And apparently now with this new release, they're going to start really pushing, so we'll see.
They can purchase this, the listeners, on all the digital platforms, though, right?
Yeah, so here's how you can really help us out. Go and hit us up on Spotify and start streaming it everywhere, right? As many different platforms as you can use to stream this, to purchase the single, to purchase the soundtrack. Streaming really, really helps us with this song specifically because that's its point, is to get the most reach. This is the first time Eva Under Fire is being introduced to anybody outside of the area on a large-scale platform, and the more you stream it, the more playlists we get on and the more, listening ears that we get. So we really would appreciate you going to any and all streaming platforms and stream Eva Under Fire, Heroin.
For anybody that does want a collector's item or physical copy, you can purchase the Snow Babies complete soundtrack on Amazon as a CD. And all the proceeds for this particular song and that soundtrack are going to the Global Recovery Initiatives Foundation. You're not just helping out a local band as we break into a national scene. You're helping out a real good cause, too.
How can everybody reach you on social media? Facebook, Instagram, you got a website and all that, correct?
Yeah, evaunderfire.com. We've got, we're still out here doing local shows, slinging merch. We might pop up on your radar because we're going to play some cover set somewhere. So there's always something that you can come and hang out with us. Pay attention to our Facebook, pay attention to our website. We're always hanging out locally. But yeah, definitely. You know, we've got Instagram and all that other good stuff too. So.
Now, did you guys participate in any of this like streaming live stuff that some of these other bands were doing?
Oh yeah, yeah. We were on Facebook Weekly for a little while there. It was Wednesday night shenanigans with Eve Wonder Flyer. We just hang out for like an hour.
Did you have to postpone a lot of shows?
Canceled, shut down. Yeah, a lot of shows.
I mean, I feel like we were scheduled to be on some tours in the summer. And
yeah.
Like that was that was just not going to happen.
Yeah,
you know?
they were pitching us to open for Shinedown and Papa Roach, and it just couldn't go through because the world shut down. So it was like major opportunities that just got indefinitely delayed. But you know,
yeah, but good things are coming for you guys. I can feel it. The new video is just well done, and this new song is amazing. The best I've heard from you guys yet, and you guys have always put out great stuff. Amanda, your voice is awesome. You're the shining example of what a female vocalist out of Detroit should be. I mean, we're all behind you. It's tough getting out of Detroit with being in a band and stuff. So, yeah, more power to you. Anything you want to leave the listeners with before we let you go?
Well, I mean, just that we feel the love, man, truly. We appreciate you having us on your podcast and all of your listeners because, I mean, as tough as it is being like a Midwest rock band, we've all been in the scene for many, many years, and we're finally at a state where we've got some opportunity that's ahead of us. And all of our people in Eva Nation, and if you follow us on all of our socials, we really do feel the love. We're grateful for all of you that joined us on our Wednesday Night Shenanigans on Facebook and our live stuff. They've come out to see us play as Undercover, where we're just playing cover sets for the whole night. I mean, it's just, nobody does it like Detroit, though, you know? I mean, truly, we've been blessed to have everybody backing us, and so we hear you guys, and we thank you so much for your support.
I just want to thank you for coming on. We're really proud of you. Give a big intro to the new song.
Thank you guys so much for listening. We are Eva Under Fire. You're checking out our new song. This one is called Heroin.